What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another shoe custom video. Before I get started, go ahead and leave a like and comment on this video. I'm going to pick the top three comments to give shoutouts to in the next video. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe. Today I'm going to be doing one of the first shoe customs that I ever watched on YouTube, which was the Jordan 1 Cartoon Customs by David Got Kicks, except I'm going to be doing it on a pair of Air Force 1s. I saw another guy do these, but he used Sharpies instead of leather paint, which is not going to hold up over time. If you want something that's going to be durable, you got to use leather paint. So I went online and I ordered some Angelus paint markers, which I'm going to be using for this custom. You can also use a small paintbrush, but there's a lot of benefits to using these, which I'll get into later. If you guys enjoy this custom, I might do it again on a black pair of Air Force 1s with white paint. Just let me know if you guys want to see that. But yeah, I'm super excited to see how these turn out. I've been wanting to do this custom for such a long time, so let's get started with the video. So I started to use the paint marker, but I completely messed it up by adding too much paint thinner. So I ended up deciding to scrap that idea and just use a regular paintbrush. I'll make another video where I use the paint markers, but I didn't feel like messing around with it too much. As always, the first step is to rub down the shoe with some leather prep and deglazer. I forgot to take out the laces, but you'll need to prep that area too. This custom is pretty simple. I'm just going to go around and outline each shape on the shoe with a solid black line. The nice thing about the Air Force 1s is that you can use the areas outside of the threading as a guideline, that way you get consistent lines. Once you get a few lines down, it already starts to get that cool cartoon effect. Now I'm going to go in and paint around the holes where the laces go. These don't have to be perfect, and it almost looks better if some of them look a little weird because drawings aren't always perfect. Now do the same thing with the holes in the front. Be careful not to get too much paint on the paintbrush when you do this. You don't want to clog up the holes, but if you do, you can use a thumbtack to clear it out. For the toe area, if you just do one line around the outside, it looks thin from the top view. So I added another line just inside the toe cap to make it look thicker. Next, I went in and painted on some cartoon stitching. You don't have to do this step, but it adds some extra detail. For the back tab, I did the same thing where I just painted a line outside of the stitching. And I also painted the Nike logo, but my camera setup is too short, so I did it off camera. Now it's time to do a line around the base of the shoe. I wanted to get a nice consistent line, so I used tape. You can easily do this without it, but I wanted to make sure it came out as even as possible. Usually it's not recommended to paint on the rubber part of the shoe, but making another line over the stitching adds a ton to the look of this custom, but just know that if you scuff your shoes, the paint will probably come off this area. Don't forget to go back and add lines to any of the areas that you might have missed earlier. Now I'm going to paint the details on the tag. If you don't have a steady hand, you should just skip over this step because it's really easy to mess up and it's hard to fix. I used an X-Acto knife and just dipped it into the paint and did it that way. This doesn't have to be perfect, as long as you can read what it says and see that there's a Nike logo, it'll look cool. And
now I'm just going to go in and add some details to the tongue. It's going to be covered by the laces, so you don't have to do the whole thing, just the areas that are going to be seen. The last step and the longest step is doing the shoelaces. There's no way to do this quickly, but if you're thorough with it, it really pays off. The way that I did it is by taping down the end of the laces and then just doing one edge at a time. You'll have to do each edge on both sides and then go back and touch up the areas on the sides where the paint isn't touching. It took me a good 3 hours to do both laces, but if you do it well, it'll be worth it. So here's the finished laces. I still have to go in and do some touch-ups off camera, but this custom is pretty much done. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to order a pair, you can message me on Instagram at Vision of My Lens. And I'll see you guys in the next video. I've been following your trail, you don't hide it well. Yeah, I should have played it safe, kept my eye on you. But I didn't, now your venom's in my bloodstream. Yeah, you got me exposed, then you dug deep. Cold-blooded, no love, I let you in, shed my skin. Cobra, cobra, cold-blooded, no love, I let you in, shed my skin.
What's going on, guys? Hold on one second.